The first step is to enter the particular link, so http://mohe.technoforhorse.com/egc. So when you, sorry. So when you click mohe.technoforhorse.com/ugc, so you will get this University of Garden City video with all the given faculties. The first step you need to do is to log in. So the login information, I will share it with your WhatsApp group. So UGC faculty and password is will be shared with you directly. So this will be the English Arabic in English. So since I need it complete English, I can change it in complete English so that it will come over like this. So this is the first page that will appear once if you enter the given username. From here, what you want to do is go to the site home. That is, if you are using English, it will be in the left side. If you are using Arabic, it will be in the right side. See, you can have two options, either English or Arabic English. Different options are there. Which one, if it is comfortable for you with Arabic, you can go with Arabic. Otherwise, let it be. So go to site home. The first step is site home. Site home, same thing, you can find all the faculty. So here, actually, we are going to do all kinds of modifications or updations or uploading the materials, etc. Okay. So unfortunately, in this mode, you cannot able to make any kinds of changes, since first you want to make the editing mode on. So in order to make editing mode on, you can find it on the right hand side, the settings. If it is in Arabic, it will be in the left hand side. So right hand side, from the settings, you need to turn the editing on. See here, before editing is on, you cannot able to find any add button over here. So when you are clicking the edit button on, you can find the add button. See, can you see it? The add button over here. Okay, that means now it is in editing mode, you can do the corresponding editing. So which faculty you are which is your faculty and what materials you are going to use. For example, here I am going to give you an example for computer studies. Let it be computer studies. So here in the slides I mentioned it as faculty of engineering. Okay, suppose if it is faculty of engineering, let it be faculty of engineering. So in faculty, when you click faculty of engineering, you can find electronics engineer, telecommunication, computer engineering, networking, medical engineering, civil engineering. So I am taking computer engineering, networking. Okay, so I'm clicking computer engineering networking. Then the next step, it will give you, you can find different semesters, that is semester 1 to semester 10. So what you are going to do, the instructions, once if you logged in, okay, logged in, you will get the different faculties, which faculty belongs to you. You need to select that faculty, but if you want to make any upload, if you want to do uploading the materials, you need to turn the editing on. When you click the turn editing on, the editing button, that is whether you are going to add any activity or a resource, that will appear over here. Okay. To which course, for example, if I'm telling about faculty of computer studies or faculty of engineering or faculty of architecture or multimedia, mass communication, etc., which one you are going to upload, you need to select that particular faculty. So once if you are clicking on faculty of computer studies, so I will get the different semesters, semester 1 to semester 8. Okay, now select your faculty, select your department, enter that particular department. If there is no specialization, like faculty of computer studies, suppose if it is faculty of electronics engineering or faculty of engineering, if you are making faculty of engineering, there will be some specialization like electronics engineering, computer engineering, medical engineering and civil engineering. Then you need to upload the materials in electronics engineering, click electronics engineering again. You will get the semester, different semesters, semester 1 to semester 10. To which semester you are going to upload the given materials, select the corresponding semester. Example, a semester 2. For example, semester 2. Okay. So, this is for this part, and the remaining will be explained in the next part. So, here we stopped up to this area in the first session. So, here we are going to add a particular course for semester 1, let it be. Okay. Anyhow, as a sample, since I am having for introduction to software engineering and software requirement engineering, so I will just to give you as a demo for introduction to software engineering. I'm going to add in semester 1. So, after selecting the semester, example like semester 1, you can find a button. So, I clicked semester 1. Okay. So, now I am in the semester 1 option. So, what you want to do first is, you want to first enter a course, add a new course. Click on add a new course. Another window will appear. That window will ask you to enter the course information, like course full name. Let me tell you, introduction to software engineering. And if there is any short name, okay, I am just writing as ISE, introduction to software engineering. This is by default for semester 1. Course visibility, show. It is show or hide. If it is hide, it will be hidden from the user. So, show, and course starting date. Starting date, let it be today's date, that is 21 July 2020, and course end date. See here, they had, by default, they had given for 1 year. So, what we can make? We can make it for 5 months or 4 months, let it be up to September. So, July to September. And course ID. So, generally in the curriculum, there will be a course ID. So, I'm making it as ISE 123. Okay, that is the first step. The next step, if there is any description for the given course, you can give the description. So, here, introduction to software engineering, which provides a fundamental of software engineering, like software engineer, scientist, programmer, etc., and software engineering skills. Okay, so the course summary that we are going to mention. And if you are having any course images, that is images for the given course, you can insert the course image over here. You can insert in two ways, either by attaching the file or adding the file or dragging the file. That is, from these in the personal category, let me book cover scholarship. So here, these are all my books. So I have that over here, introduction to software engineering. I can drag it over here directly. Either I can drag it over here. So drag the given image. So you can find it over here now. So it is taking time because the internet speed is a little bit low. So introduction to software engineering .png. See, these are all the three file types, .gif, .jpg or .png files. These are all the three files. It will be acceptable over here. So either you can drag and drop, or you can download. Either you can drag and drop, or what you can do is, you can go to the particular folder, select it, and then attach. Two way we can do. Okay. Then the next one is the course format. So, there are totally four formats. Single activity. If you are having only a single activity, if you are having social format, then comes topics format and weekly format. So, generally, we will use either topics format or weekly format, like topics 1, topic 2, topic 3, like that, or week 1, week 2, etc., like that. Okay. And the other sections you can keep. The next one is regarding the number of sections. Generally, for every semester, we are having 14 to 15 weeks. Okay. For time being, let us take only 5 weeks. because it's a demonstration section. Then you can use two buttons, either save and return or save and display. If you are going to save and return, if you use save and return, it will return to the course page. Or if you are clicking save and display, it will display the given page. So I'm just clicking save and return. So what will happen? It will take you to the course page. So we already used in another course. See here, this one I already introduced in software engineering, that is in the faculty of computer studies. So I can make it as, let it be 1. And okay, this one, let it be 4. I think the same. No. It can be, it is okay. So now save and return. Now the course introduction, that is the course page, it enters into the course page. That is the end of this session. Okay. So from the course window, select the course name. So the course page will appear with because we gave 5 topics. That 5 topics will be appear over there. The first, the announcement section, then topic 1, topic 2, topic 3, topic 4, and topic 5. The announcement section generally used for uploading any announcement about the course, then assignments, course syllabus, course outline, any course related information, etc. Suppose and even for some chats, means the most relevant information, like an announcement, if you are going to provide the students, so that will be uploaded in the announcement section. Then in the topic section, we are generally uploading the subject materials, like the lecture notes in PowerPoint or in PDF or in Word format, or even some YouTube links or even web pages, etc., etc. So if you want to change, the topic, that is this, if you want to change, that means the topic text, if you want to change into lecture 1 or week 1 or chapter 1, etc. From the edit button, you click on the edit button and just type lecture 1. Okay, just type lecture 1. And if you use the mouse for entering this new text, it will not change. So for that, what do you want to do? You need to enter. Okay, so topic 1, change it to lecture 1. That is, if you want to change topic 1 to lecture 1, select the pen icon on the right side of the topics and enter a new name, example lecture 1, and then press enter. The topic 1 is now changed to lecture 1. Okay, the same can be done for other topic also, like topic 2. Again, here we are making it as lecture 2, and then press enter. Okay, just remember, we need to use press enter, and like that for third one, lecture 3, then press enter, and topics 3 will be changed to lecture 3, like that for all lecture 4, then enter, and lecture 5, then click enter. Okay. So other than enter, no other actions will change the given text. Okay. So in the previous section, we discussed up to this introduction to software engineering course creation, and then the different lecture materials creation. Suppose if I missed anything, please excuse me. So here we created for 5 lectures. If you want to add more lectures, here there is an option that is add topics. If you click add topics, it will ask you for number of sections. Let me tell you 2 sections. Already we are having 5 sections. If you add 2, it should comes a total of 7 sections. See here, topic 6 and topic 7. If you want to change topic to lecture, type lecture 6 and enter. Like that for topic 7, type lecture 7 and enter. Okay, if you want to delete from the edit button, you can delete the topic. The topic will be deleted. Okay, so again, I'm just deleting because we mentioned that we need only five lectures. So these are all the 1 to 5 lecture section. So in order to enter to the course material, it may be announcements, it may be lecture materials, what we need is we need to click on the add or create add an activity or resource button. Okay, before going to this, let me tell you, if you are going to add the lecture materials and other related documents, for example, just create a folder and copy all the information in one place so that it will be easy for you instead of searching everywhere. See, here in my case, what I had done, I created the Introduction to Software Engineering 4 module in one place, which contains, for example, like assignment, the course contents, okay, course syllabus, then course contents. So course assignment, just see, you can see it is written in the Word document, like assignment 1, the due date Monday, September 6, 2020. There are the question number 1 with 15 points, question 2 with 15 points, etc. It depends. Means in which way you are planning to make the assignment. For this assignment, submit a PDF file. So I had given a condition also. The student should submit it in PDF version. Then comes the course syllabus. So course syllabus, like module 1 to module 4, and the recommended textbook. Either you can make it in the image form, or you can write it book number 1, book number 2, book number 3, like that. Then comes the course content. So in the first syllabus category, we made only outline. Here it is giving you in module 1, how many lectures are there and what are the topics of that particular lecture. In module 2, how many lectures are there. Module 3, how many lectures are there. And in module 4, how many lectures are there. Then afterwards, see here, from here to here, it is a PowerPoint presentation of my lecture materials. So if you click the first one, you can find the lecture materials of chapter 1. The chapter 1 lecture materials, like that, for other chapter 1 to chapter 7. Then I also created a PDF file, the PDF file for the first lecture, like that for remaining. See, since it is like a demo, I am not included all. Then comes software engineering question bank. Suppose if you want to provide them some additional features or some additional information, like question banks, like question number 1, question and answer, question number 2, question and answer, like that. It will be something like an additional benefits or additional information for the students. Then comes software engineering interview questions. There are some interview questions are being provided. See here, interview questions are being provided. Then comes the YouTube links. For example, if I want to provide them with the video, I have created the YouTube information. So this is making it easy. For example, Introduction to Software Engineering video lecture link, I created a total of 24 parts, and each part, this is the duration. And when you are making, try to make the duration less than 15. If it is more than 15, that like 20 minutes, 30 minutes, 1 hour, the size will be like 1 GB, 2 GB and all. And also, it will be difficult for the students to download it, the present internet tariff and all here in Sudan. So first introduction, and this is a YouTube link. I can directly copy the YouTube link and paste where I can make it. So these are all the information that I provided in the particular subject. So whenever I am going to attach the given information, it will become easy for me to find. If you are creating, for example, some of the information in documents, some of the information in downloads, some of the information is in any one of the folder. So it is always difficult for us to search from here. It will take some time. Instead of that, make everything in one place so that it will become easy for you to upload the given materials. So as I mentioned, normally in the announcement section, we are going to provide the important assignments or important information to the students, like assignment, for example, the course syllabus, for example, course contents, for example, some question bank, for example, chat, information, for example, like that, some information we are going to provide it in the announcement phase. So in order to enter the course information or the course material, click on the add an activity or resources tab. So when you click on the add an activity resource tab, you can find the activity resource tab. So the first portion is activities and the second portion is the resources. So resources category, generally we are using to provide proper services to the students, like if you want to include a book, if you want to include a file, if you want to include a folder, if you want to include these multimedia contents, if you want to include a label, or if you want to provide a page or URL. This will be described in the next section. So here, in the first case, we are going to provide with assignment, then chat, then choice, then database, then external tool, feedback, forum, glossary, lesson, quiz, SCOM package, then zip files, survey, wiki, and live class like Zoom and workshop. Okay. Since we are in the beginning stage, I'm just going to give you a few items, because gradually we can go through the remaining. So I am going to provide you with assignment. So what I'm going to do is that I'm going to provide the assignment in the announcement section. Already you saw in my folder I had created one assignment. So in order to get the assignment, click on add an activity resource, click on the assignment button and click add. So the assignment dialog box will appear, or assignment window will appear. In this assignment, in this section, you need to give the assignment name. So for example, software engineering assignment number 1. So if you want to provide any description for the given assignment, so notes, there are 7 questions, like point number 1, there are 7 questions. Then second, students are advised to answer all questions. The submission must be in PDF format, etc., etc., etc. And if you want to display this in the course page, you can select it. And additional information, that is, you need to provide the file. So what I'm going to do, I'm just adding the file by uploading. So click on the upload file button, the upload window will appear. Sorry, because I switched off the internet connection, that's why. Click on the upload file. So choose the file. So where I saved all the file? In the desktop. Okay, so I'm going to the desktop, the folder ISC Moodle, and I have the assignment number 1 that I'm opening. That means I'm going to upload that particular file. Now the file is being uploaded over here. Okay, and then next one is the availability. When you want to, that is allow the submission. When you are going to allow the students to submit 21st July to the due date and cutoff date, which date? So if it is, if you want to have the cutoff date, you can enable it. Otherwise, you can disable it. And remind me to grade by. So grading will be done. That's all the second session, which is not explained over here. Then comes the submission section. So you need for the students to submit either as an online text or a file submission. So if it is online text, means it will be directly. So you can give the word limit by enabling, but we already given the condition over there that the student should submit it as file submission. So we can just disable it. So file should be submitted with the 50 MB to the maximum. Accepted file types. So the file types, they had given a number of choices, like all file types, archive files, audio files, natively supported by browser, audio files used on the web, document files, like the different documents. So in the document file, okay, we click the document file and we mentioned that we need only PDF. So select the PDF file. Okay, that's all. Like that, many different formats are there. So save the changes. So here, the document should be in the PDF file. Okay, and the remaining things keep as it is by default and save and return to the course. If you are saving and return to the course, you can find, see here, the software engineering assignment number with the notes which I provided over there. When the students click over here, they can directly download the given assignment. This is the first session. So this section, let us go to the next, that is chat. Okay, before that, I forgot to tell you one thing. Here we inserted this information by uploading the materials. So instead of uploading the materials, we can do in another way. Let me delete it first. So it is being deleted. And in another way, we can upload the materials rather than going with the add an activity resource. Directly we can do by drag and drop method. For that, you just go to the given folder, which folder that is from the desktop. Okay, go to the particular folder and select the assignment and drag and place it just under assignment. So now actually as announcement is the heading and assignment is a sub section. So we can just use like a tab option. We can move it little bit forward. For that, go to edit and move to the right. So it is moved a little bit right. Again, if you want to move to the right, it can be moved again. So if you want to move it back, go to edit and move to the left. The same way. So the same way we can insert the other information, for example, like course syllabus, then course contents, then comes software engineering question bank, then software engineering interview questions, etc. So in this way we can upload the materials. Instead of going for uploading all the time, we can drag and drop the information. Okay, so next let us go to the next section, that is about chat. So chatting normally an activity generally used for chatting with the students whenever they have some doubts, etc. and so if you want to chat, then just click on chat. So chat sections are saved and can be made available for everyone. So select the chat and click the add button. So the chat window will appear. Here you want to give the name of the chat, for example, software engineering chat section. Then if there is any description for the given chat section, you can give the description. And the chat section, we can make the timing. For example, here it is given as 21. We can make it as 25, for example. 25, for example, and the remaining. Okay. Then repeat or publish session times. If you don't want to publish any chat items, you can do that. Or if you want to repeat or not to repeat, or at the same time every day or at the same time every week, so we can make the changes. If you want to delete the message, you can delete. If you don't want to delete the message, that also we can do. Remaining things as it is, and then just save and return to the course page. Now the software engineering chat section is displayed over there. Now if you want to chat, just to click on the software engineering chat section, the software engineering chat section will appear. Here, click to enter to chat now. If you want to chat now, you can click on the particular link. So the chat window will appear. The chat window will appear. There you can start making the chat. Okay, so this is from e-learning, that is from the university. So if the students are enrolled, they will be appear on the right side, and you can select, or the students can either chat with you, or you can select a particular student for the given chatting. Anyhow, I'm not going to enter over here for time being. Let me see. Okay, the time is just four. Okay. Then again, going back to the subject section. So now what the thing is that it is not aligned properly. So announcement is the heading, and assignment, course contents, course syllabus, software engineering, question bank, etc. are the subsection. So we can move everything forward on little so that it will comes under the announcement in a unique way. Okay, now everything comes under a unique way. Then comes choice. So this is like asking a single question, and for that question there will be multiple answers. So for doing so, select the particular choice and click add, and click the and type the choice name. So software engineering simply, and if you have any description, you can provide the description. And then we are having option one, like A, so and so, B, so and so, etc. And then if you want to add field, you can add, and the remaining portion you can keep as it is as default, and then save and return to the course page. But now anyhow, I'm not going to enter any choice over here. Okay. Then comes database, that is for the records, like row and column format. Then external tools, that is for providing the students with some websites from outside area. See here, I have two sections, like the past exam papers, software in software engineering, as well as software engineering exam questions and answers. If I want to include that one, I can give directly the link that is been provided over here. So external link, I can give the link which is been provided over here, or like these links I can include, so that the students can able to go and get those information. Then comes feedback. This is feedback generally used for the teacher to create some information. Then forum, discussion forum, glossary, like dictionary. Then comes lesson. The teacher can create a linear set of content pages or instructional activities that can offer a variety of paths. It means like linked pages. Then comes a quiz. Then SCOM page. It is generally used as a zip file, so we can upload the file in a zip format. We use SCOM package. Then comes survey, exactly like the forum or feedback. Then goes with wiki pages. Then WizIQ live classes like Zoom. But if you want to use it here, surely we need what I can tell, the VPN, virtual private network. So actually, the resources are the main thing that we need for our e-learning course. The remaining things are optional. We can tell optional because we are not going to use all the features. We are using only very features, like assignment, for example, then chat, for example, then choices, multiple choice question, for example, then some forums or feedback. Then when we are going with lecture one, so let us click in order to enter the resources. Click on the add an activity or resource button. Again, the add an activity resource window will appear. In that, you can include the resources starting with book. Here, in the sense how you are having a book in the hard copy form, the same thing you can create in the soft copy way, like chapter 1, then sub chapters, then chapter 2, sub chapters, subheading, etc., etc., like that. So let us go with that one. So create a book. So click, in order to create a book, click on the book option and then click add. So adding a new book to lecture one. So we are giving the book name Software Engineering Book. And if there is any description, you can give the description, appearance, chapter formatting like numbers, etc. Remaining you can keep as it is. And click on save and return to course. So here, software engineering book, that the primary section that we entered. Now we need to upload, or we need to update the given information. For that, click on the software engineering book, give the chapter name. So chapter one. And then you need to give the contents. For chapter 1, you need to give the content. So here I am taking this from here. Sorry, from here I am going to take, okay, software engineering overview. So just let me take a little bit from here. I'm just taking and copying the given information in the chapter. So copy and, so what I had done, so I just copied and pasted it. Now here you can make modifications in the text and all. Suppose if you need this one, the first heading, if it is to the middle, so from the down arrow you can make it into center, and you can make it bold case, italics, etc. And here this one, now it came something like a web link. Okay, so I like that. This also you can make it into the middle with a bold case, etc. With a bold case, etc. Okay, and now if you want to enter any tags, okay, like the keywords, keywords we use it in the research paper, like that we can do. Then just click save changes. So now the changes are being saved. Can you see it over here? Chapter 1. So software engineering book, we got chapter 1. So chapter 1, like that. Okay, if you need to delete, you can delete. If you need to hide from the students, you can hide. And if you want to make any edit, you can edit over here. And this one is used for a new chapter that will come after chapter 1. So if you click plus, a new chapter option, that is now we are entering chapter 2. And like the like before previous, we are going to enter the chapter 2 information, software quality. Just not many, just a small information, so that we are pasting it over here. So let it be in bold case, let it be in bold case, and let it be in the middle. Okay, and then save changes. So chapter 2 will be created over here. See here, chapter 2 will be created over here. Like that for chapter 3, chapter 4. You can add anything. You can add not only these, you can add. See, for example, let me tell about chapter 3. So in chapter 3, I'm going with the chapter 3. I'm going with the chapter 3 and the contents. Let me tell software engineering models, chapter, this is the chapter 3. This is the chapter 3. So this one to the middle. And I'm just making it the bold case. See here, in this case, suppose if you want to enter an image, you can enter the image. Okay, so first I will enter the image of my book itself, just for temporary. Book cover sheet, introduction to software engineering, let me fundamentals of software engineering. So I enter, so it will be uploaded. Okay, then image must have a description, except okay, describe the image, software engineering. Fundamentals of software engineering. Save the image. Size auto size. Okay, save the image. The image has been saved. Okay, the image has been saved. Now, the same way, if you want to enter an audio or video file, you can enter an audio file. So I don't have any audio file at the present moment, but for time being, just I am entering a song. Just I am entering a song here. Then save the given file. It is taking too much time.
load. Okay, do we have anything else? Okay, let me use another one, smaller size.
So if the internet speed is high, we no need to worry, it will be uploaded immediately, but due to the speed of the internet, it is taking time. So you can upload the media file like this. Okay, it is taking time. See, only you can see here only 28% is uploaded. See, can you see it over here in the downside? You can see it 29%. So okay, I will just leave it. You can add even audio files. You can add even video files. You can record the audio. You can record the video, or you can manage multiple files, etc. So save the changes. Now I save the given changes. So here chapter 3 is also included. See, you can see chapter 3 with the software engineering, the content software engineering models with the corresponding image. Okay, so I'm going back to that area, lecture area. So here software engineering book is already created. The next thing, the most important thing that we need, that is about adding the file. So you can add, click on the file option, you can add a file. So it will ask you for the file name. For example, if you are mentioning about lecture one material. If you need any description, you can give the description. You can select the file by uploading it. So in my case, it is in the desktop. It is in ISC Moodle. So software engineering lecture one. So that I attached. Now upload the given file. It will be uploaded. See here, due to the internet speed, can you see here it is uploading like 31%, 33, 34, 36, like that. It is uploading very slowly. If the speed is okay, we can upload. It will be uploaded very fast. See, 72%. Yes, it is uploaded now. Now remaining, you can keep as by default, save and return to the course. It will be, that information will be saved. See here, lecture one material, that is being saved over here. Okay. Then the next one, the same way. Okay, I'm just deleting it. The same way you can upload by drag and drop. So just I'm deleting it to show you how we can able to do by drag and drop. So here, just make it minimize and first introduction lecture. So you can just keep it by drag and drop. So the first lecture is entered over there, insert over there. The same way you can do it for lecture 2, lecture 3, lecture 4, and lecture 5. So okay, let it get uploaded. The next one is folder. See, in the folder, in the sense, you can create a folder and you can attach more than one file. So folder, if you want to create, okay, that is attached. If you want to create a folder, select the folder option and click add option. and it will ask you for the folder name. So I create SC folder, software engineering folder, and for the contents. Okay, here it will ask you for the contents. You can see here for this, instead of going to the file option, add, upload option, what you can do is that you can upload multiple files at the same time. So I am just uploading, see, as a demo I am telling, because it is for chapter 2, lecture 2, lecture 3, lecture 4 and lecture 5, but just to show you how to insert multiple files in a single folder. So what I had done is that I am just to drag and drop all the information. So it is uploading chapter 3, then it will upload chapter 4, it will upload chapter 5, etc. And then click save and return to the course. Okay, let it be uploaded. See, chapter 3 is uploaded, then chapter 4 is uploaded, then chapter 5, etc. like that. So multiple files we are uploading at the same time, like a folder. Like, see here, in this given folder, I uploaded many files. The same way, it will appear over here. See here, multiple files are uploaded. Save and return to the course. It will take you back to the course page. Now you can see, so we have created a folder. Okay, and next, it is not completed, that's why. Yeah, the next one, in this case, that is IMS content package. So in the IMS content package, you can see it over here. It may be used for mainly presenting multimedia and animations, but unfortunately I don't have any multimedia or animated folder, so just I am cancelling. Then goes to the label, in the sense, like a heading, we can highlight the given label. So just give the label name, just the label name I'm giving, software engineering, software engineering lecture materials. Save and return to the course. So the label is been entered over here. So you can move this information from one to another. For example, if you want to provide this course syllabus to be first, you can drag and drop, means you can just move from one place to another, like course syllabus to the first, then course content to the second, course contents, there it is. Okay, course contents. Course contents of page used. Edit. I think it duplicated. Okay. Like that, software engineering lecture material, this is like a label, it can be entered in the first section. Okay. Then comes the next activity, that is about page. So it is used for the teacher to create a web page resource. Like the chapter we created, too, same way we can create. Then comes the next step is URL. So mainly in the resource category, we are using, for example, book, files, folders, and URL. And URL, that indicates if you want to enter a URL for the particular chapter from YouTube video or other videos, etc. So name, I'm just making it as lecture 1 video materials. You can enter the URL by choosing it. You are directly going to the YouTube search for it. So here, if I am going with the online GK online learning, so this is my YouTube channel, and please subscribe to my channel for continuous support. So you can find all my videos over here. You can find all my videos over here, which contains, for example, for mathematics, some skills, means some tips. And now I added the e-learning workshop part 1, part 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8 that will follow. And at the end, you can find software engineering part 7, then software requirement engineering part 7, introduction to software engineering part 14. So here, somewhere, introduction to software engineering part 1 is there. So when you click over this, you can find the given video. You can find the given video with this YouTube link. But what I had done is that I already created the YouTube links over here. So here, for copy and paste the given URL, I can directly go to the YouTube link, for example, the introduction. So here you will have the YouTube link. Just copy the YouTube link and you can paste it over here. You can paste it over here. And then if you have any description, you can describe it and save and return. Save and return to the course. It will take you back to the course page. Looks like the internet is too slow today. So here, lecture 1 video materials. If you click on the lecture 1 video materials, it will take you directly to the corresponding YouTube video. See here, it will take you directly to the YouTube video. So here, it will show you the video.
For a specific,
so this is the video. Okay, then going back, so these are all about the same way. You can do it for lecture 2, lecture 3, lecture 4, and lecture 5. Okay, so in lecture 1, in the announcement section, we included course syllabus, assignments, course contents, software engineering question bank, software engineering interview questions, software engineering chat section. And in lecture 1, we included the software engineering book. We created the software engineering book. We uploaded introduction to software engineering 1. We created a folder and we created a lecture materials. That's all in this section. And then we will go to the last section. Last section, see, actually what I had done, so I entered the lecture materials in electronics engineering, that is for telecommunication, and I entered introduction to software engineering, which does not belong, this subject belong, does not belong to them. Suppose if you want to delete the course which is been removed from the curriculum, or which has been updated, or whatever it may be, means you need to change the complete contents of this particular course. What you can do, you can delete the course from the particular section. For that, what you want to do is that, since you are an administrator, that's why I'm telling it again and again, since you are an administrator, you have the privilege to cancel the courses or cancel anything from this particular site. So in the left hand side, you can find the site administration. Go to the site administration and then click on the courses. Click on the courses, and in that you can manage courses and category. And on the right side, you can see view course categories and courses. From that, click on the courses. Click on the courses. So we created it in electronic and faculty of engineering, electronics engineering, telecommunication. So we included in semester 1. So when it is been taken into that particular faculty, you can see Introduction to Software Engineering is been there. You can select it and then click delete. The particular course will be deleted from that faculty. Okay, so continue. Now you just go and check in the site home. You just go and check Electronics Engineering. So Electronics and Engineering Telecommunication, we included it in the semester one. But unfortunately, we cannot able to find in semester one any course over here because just now we deleted the particular course. Okay, that's all about this workshop. If you are having any doubts, any queries, any problems, any challenges, you can mail to me or you can contact me at any time. Okay, thank you. Thank you for listening. And this is the last section in the e-learning workshop. If you are having any queries, if you are having any problems, if you are having any doubts, please write to me to the mail ID or the telephone number provided over there. Thanks for your participation and thanks for your patience. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel for continuous support. Thank you. Thank you all. We'll meet you again.